Hello, my name is Kevin McCarthy. I'm a minimally invasive spine surgeon at the Spine Center of Baton Rouge. And today I'm going to be talking about a minimally invasive treatment for low back pain. So in the lower back, we have a series of small joints called the facet joints. And you can see them here on this model. These small joints move as the back moves and stabilize the spine. Similar to other joints in the body, such as the knee and hip, these joints can become inflamed and painful. And when they do, they cause lower back pain. And oftentimes the lower back pain can be excruciating. Typically, facet-related back pain is worse when the patient extends the back or arches back, or when they stand from a sitting position. Common treatments for facet-related pain initially include medication, physical therapy, and at times, injections. In this first diagram, we see the distribution of pain that patients typically experience from the facet joints. And as you can see, facet joint pain can cause pain in the lower back all the way down to the buttocks and upper thighs. The next diagram shows the anatomy of the facet joint, and you can see a small branch of the large nerve comes off and attaches to the facet joint, and this is the medial branch nerve that tells the brain that these facet joints are hurting. And this specific tiny little nerve can be targeted with procedural treatments. This next diagram again shows a treatment that targets this medial branch nerve as it branches off from the large nerve and attaches to the facet joint. In this case, the nerve is being targeted and burned through a heating probe. So patients that present with low back pain, and it's thought to be related to their facet joints, we confirm that with a diagnostic injection. That's a procedure where we inject a tiny bit of numbing medication right around that nerve. And if the patient's back pain goes away, we know that the pain is coming from this joint. In patients that have relief with that diagnostic injection, they are candidates for a minimally invasive procedure targeting that small little nerve. And that's called a rhizotomy procedure. Now, traditionally, rhizotomies have been done through a traditional percutaneous technique using just a needle. Now, this is a procedure where a needle is placed down to the area where the nerve is thought to be based on anatomy knowledge, and a heat probe is placed through that needle, and it's raised to a certain temperature to allow us to burn that nerve. The problem with this procedure is you're not specifically seeing the nerve or confirming that you're getting that nerve, so there's some failure rate to this procedure. A newer technique that's used through a minimally invasive fashion is an endoscopic rhizotomy. Now, endoscopic procedures are done using a scope, similar to what we use in a shoulder scope or a knee scope. It allows us to put the camera into the spine through a tiny little poke incision and look and actually find that little nerve that's going to the facet joint. So under direct visualization, using a radio frequency probe or a laser, we can burn that nerve under direct visualization and know that we're definitely getting the targeted nerve that we're going after. And through that process, we're able to take away the pain that's coming from that facet joint and give patients that have had back pain for years relief. So in this live video of an actual procedure, we can see the nerve actually being burned under direct visualization, severing the nerve in half, disrupting that communication of pain to the brain. And as a result, this patient's back pain would be markedly improved or gone. I've been performing this procedure at the Spine Center in Baton Rouge for greater than 10 years. The endoscopic rhizotomy is a minimally invasive procedure that's an improvement on a traditional technique. Patients have done very well. We've had great outcomes in appropriately selected patients. If you'd like to know more information about the endoscopic rhizotomy procedure, check our website for information or call and make an appointment and come and discuss it with us.